Just a few weeks ago, Rocket Lab re-entered the launch market, a long way to break since their unfortunate September mission failure that occurred when the two Electron stages attempted to separate. In this video, I'll go over the history of this very special rocket company and its launch vehicles that punch way above its weight in the industry. I'll also touch on its big goals to enter the reusable medium lift launch market with Neutron. First up, Electron. Rocket Lab and Electron are both based on extremely humble beginnings. The footage you are seeing now is the first rocket Rocket Lab sent to orbit, the RTO-1. This rocket, constructed in employees' garages, transported in the back of a ute, and controlled by some guys in a container, was actually the first Southern Hemisphere vehicle to pass the Kármán line, the internationally recognized boundary for space. Although this 5-meter tall hobby rocket wouldn't propel Rocket Lab very far, and so the Electron was born. This practical 18-meter launch vehicle, which can carry 300 kilograms to low Earth orbit using its two-stage system, first of which is being developed for reusable purposes, is focused on practicality and manufacturability. From the ashes of this rocket's first flight in 2017, Rocket Lab's Electron launch vehicle has risen to the top of the spaceflight industry, racking up over 80 successful launches and delivering payloads for everyone from NASA to private satellite operators. It hasn't been a perfectly smooth trajectory though. A couple of stumbles along the way have served as stark reminders of the spaceflight industry's unforgiving nature. But with each bump, Rocket Lab has emerged stronger, learning, adapting, and ultimately proving their worth. To date, the Kiwi company has launched 42 Electron rockets. This is a frequency of launch only paralleled by industry giants and SpaceX. In fact, Electron has played a key component in NASA's Artemis program, which I'll do a video on in the near future. The mission, named Capstone, was used to test out the halo orbit that NASA will utilize for the Gateway Space Station. Sorry, there's a lot of analogies, that's how spaceflight works. This mission was a resounding success, and the microwave satellite is still orbiting the moon in this way as we speak. Part 2, Neutron. Rocket Lab is about to unleash another revolution, a beast clad in carbon composite, fueled by the brute force and efficiency of methane engines, designed to glide back to Earth for a fiery but reusable end to the mission. That's Neutron, a launch vehicle poised to rewrite the rulebook on affordability and versatility. Its heart lies in the revolutionary first stage, built from lightweight yet incredibly strong carbon composite. Forget the clunky steel giants of yesterday, Neutron aims to be the rocket of 2050. Neutron sheds valuable weight without sacrificing quality, enabling a payload capacity of a whopping 13 tons. And its key component? This stage doesn't end its story in a splashdown or fiery inferno, it returns to land, ready for its next journey into space, preferably only after a few days or a few weeks of refurbishment. Think of it as a cosmic taxi, dropping off your satellites and then cruising back for another ride. But the good doesn't stop there. The second stage, powered by those efficient methane engines, can also potentially join the reusable club. Imagine the savings, the environmental benefits, the deadly combo of a two-stage reusable launch vehicle. Rocket Lab is betting on agility and innovation. They're building Neutron for the future, where rapid reusability fuels a spacefaring boom. But Neutron's not just about saving bucks, it's about unlocking possibilities. Its massive payload lets it tackle constellation deployments, hauling dozens of satellites at a time, deep space missions as well, and even more exciting, the possibility of human spaceflight. Maybe, but it would be awesome to see some Rocket Lab astronauts. Rocket Lab aims for this vehicle to be not just that, but instead a gateway for unlimited-ish access to space. Sounds oddly familiar, doesn't it? Looks like we have a bit of a clash here. Neutron versus Starship, the space industry's heavyweight showdown. Starship, a behemoth promising moon trips, overshadows Neutron's smaller payload. But here's the twist. Neutron's agility and focus on smaller satellite taxi rides could carve a niche in the booming market. While Starship rewrites interplanetary rules, Neutron could quietly democratize near-Earth space. So don't expect a winner-takes-all. Both rockets play distinct roles in the evolving game of accessibility, so watch the sky. The future of spaceflight isn't a winner-takes-all environment. It's most likely going to become a constellation of different vehicles taking up different purposes in the one-day colossal market of space travel. From backyard beginnings to industry leader, Rocket Lab's Electron soared against expectations. Now Neutron enters the arena, a reusable beast redefining affordability and versatility. Neutron's carbon fiber heart carries 13 tons, returning like a cosmic taxi for rapid-fire spacefaring. But it's not just cost-saving, it's about possibilities, constellations, deep space, maybe even astronauts. Neutron unlocks near-Earth space for all. Regardless, it's going to be a great future for spaceflight, and I hope you're excited as me to ride it out.